Guys, what's happening? Keep his glands open, maybe. Ibi, look here. Yay. Oh. Ibi. Shit.
Don't fucking prank your life.
Yeah, no shit. Hold on. Where's that Ikea? Luke, come help. Come help, okay? Philip, Ibi.
Yeah, he's a new one. I know. I know. All the time, I have this in the back of my mind. So, welcome to another episode of On the Couch Advocate. And today we've got a very cool guest, Benjamin Derek, also known as Bennie, to most people out there. Bennie, we'd like to say welcome very much to another episode of On the Couch with Luca.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for taking the time out to come and actually do it with us. Much appreciated.
No, honor is mine.
And then we're always honored to have good guests like yourself over here.
You haven't really met me yet.
No, but I've been watching you. And it's good for the soul.
Guys, this is going to be a very different episode. Look, and you're probably going to see me laughing throughout the episode, but following Uncle Benny's Facebook page, I haven't seen a serious moment, so just looking at him and I'm thinking of all the posts and things that I saw on Facebook. And I'm sure you guys are going to enjoy this one. So let's kick it straight off. Tell us, where did you start off your fishing career?
Yeah, that's when I plank good at this.
Okay. The movie says take one. Right.
Yeah, thanks so much, E.B. Lance. It's really a privilege. Yeah, and I think it's about, I mean, we all share the same passion, and I think ultimately that's what it's about. My late grandfather used to have a holiday home in Hans Bay, at which he ultimately retired. And yeah, it was school holidays. It was that school I clock Lenoch and so it was in the car, and my mom went and dropped me there. But it was magical. We fished from us bunker in the harbor. We caught crayfish in between the dollars. So we scuba dived. We went to the grijs, to the plaat. Actually, in standard 5, I was very ill the third semester in what today's grade 7. Okay. I had geelsig, what's it?
Jaundice.
Yeah.
And my mom, was a handful by the house, so she's not to blame by the house at the grace. So she took me, I was supposed to be out of direct sunlight, but Opa says it's a good opposite. So it was like, so for, yeah, so best 3 months of my life. Hans Bay, Piet Otto, Piet Bokki, Opa Ben de Waal. Ali Gans by legends, yeah, so that was quite special.
So that's where it started in Gans by?
Yeah, I think that the road they stayed in is still a gravel road. We was it pen 500s gegooid on that path, like bloed hier by your dime uitloop. But yeah, so.
So guys, I need to tell you this. So normally myself and Lawrence would study the guest that's coming in. And then we would know how the discussion goes, what we can ask, how we can. But in true Bennie style, he gave us a sheet of a bit of detail.
He gave us each one a copy, guys. Here's my copy.
So we just want to share that. But in any case, we're going to work a little bit off this because it gives us some pointers.
Yeah.
So, right. So, Hans by, straight by. Just tell us, we're just going to jump a bit. Tell us your fishing spots, but before you come to, what is your favorite aspect of fishing in terms of rock and surf? So more surf, more rock, kayaking, boating, diving. Speak to us. Give us a bit more detail about yourself, and then we're going to touch on what we can give back.
Yeah, I would have to say I probably come from a boating background. Surf fishing is relaxing, I guess, but that's why I love this. I call it the Southeast Coast, to be on the rocks. There's yeah. Places like Eysturfontein and these where I've never done it, but I'll leave my rods up at the house for 2 hours on a spring low and just walk amongst the holes and things. It's pristine, untouched. It's absolutely beautiful. Yeah.
So
I do enjoy the
so rocks is your favorite. You know what, I think most anglers love the rocks. I think it's also to do with the species that you get around the rocks. Yeah. You can scratch for a small fish, you can chase a big fish.
Also the adrenaline, when you
are
with
that
fish.
And at the adrenaline, yeah.
You one with the sea, you're standing in the sea, exactly. The fish is swimming, they say you're being a deer, and
Pick and Kobeni.
Right, guys, as you guys know, actually, Kobeni just told us he's not a storyteller, he takes offense. He tells the truth. So all the stories that he tells.
Should I be looking at you or the camera?
Whichever, you can look at the people, you can look at us.
When you tell your story, look at it.
I just need to touch on a story. So this is how I came across Kobeni for the first time. I saw a video, or it was a photo, one of the two, where you were actually standing on Makassar with the Dorado, which is Omai, or Dolphin Fish. And I think you told the people you caught it in Makassar.
Yeah, again.
What's the story behind
it? I was really interested in doing long casting competitions. It was for me to be able to get to species like angel and ike and these sort of things that guys don't
to get the Dorado now as well.
Yeah,
and all the species from the shore.
From the shore, okay. Yeah. Sure. So I started that, and in the beginning it was rather difficult because the bait, because of those scars, your bait can be in the air for like 5 to 6 minutes. And then you
are you serious?
Yeah. And you lose
serious?
Yeah. And you lose a lot of flavor.
Come on. No worries. Look at I'm checking this 350 plus meters, 5 minutes in the air, bait losing flavor.
Yeah. No, it's a lot of people. Look, if you haven't done it, it's difficult to comprehend. But yeah, so I had to develop techniques first of all to contain the flavor of the bait and so on. And yeah, and then my first hookup was actually was an angelfish, just off Oz Monkeys. Which I love, and then I study the conditions. I've got friends in KZN that I regularly talk with on a regular basis, and he said to me they spotted shoals and what have you. So they were actually, it was difficult because with a long casting you don't hold back on a cast because rhythm is very important. So what I do is I saw that shoal was in at about 280, so I would have casted over them. So then I moved back on the beach.
You know, I'm going to be honest. Are you being serious? Can I take it serious on this one?
Well,
take him serious.
I said in the beginning. I mean, there's no reason for me to. Yeah.
Okay, so you needed to cost 280. So you walk back. How far back?
That is why you'll always see wherever I cast, I need to have ample space. To move. I can't fish right up against the.
Okay, this is a good one. This is the first meeting. This is a good one.
I just put it in the zone. It was fast. Yeah, beautiful.
And you got the Dorado from Makassar.
Yeah.
I'll try and find the photo and then
see what it is. I've got so many photos on my. But yeah, I'll put the weekend.
What bait did you catch it on?
Oki leg. Yeah. the you'll find that the Oki leg that was, as I said, when it comes to flavor retention. So what we actually do is I cover it with sand. So you take the Oki leg, take a skin off, cover it in sand, let it dry. You can also do like a panko breadcrumb. And then it was fasty. Betty's my uncle owns a home right next to Thompson Clip.
Okay.
So I get a paar visse of Thompson Clip and I beach a fang, Betty's. I actually don't like talking. I get teary eyed with this. Betty's is a very, very good friend of mine. I think he also had a YouTube channel, Victor Hogan from Salt Lake.
Okay.
The late Victor Hogan.
What do you mean the late Victor Hogan? Too much is that?
Victor Salt Lake.
Yes.
What do you mean the late?
He's passed away.
Victor?
Yeah.
And I spoke to him other day.
When?
A few weeks ago.
Victor.
Because I asked
Victor.
Him. We spoke about it regarding the podcast as well. Oh, you mean Victor's dad?
No, Victor himself.
So, darling Victor.
Yeah, he's still, I'm sure he's around. Are you sure? Okay, what might you say he's passed on? How do you know?
Oh, no, just I haven't seen him with a fish for 2 years. Groot man,
Victor, sorry, man.
Victor's always take my jokes.
Guys, he's not. Guys, Victor is well in alive and practicing for his new distance of discus. Yeah. He's a SA Olympus.
He won gold, I think, a month ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
Listen,
like you mentioned, you talk with your Khali, you talk with your Dorado from Akasa. Tell me, don't you talk with Elf or anything like that? You
see, favorite species.
Is it? Mm. Okay. Tell us about that.
Yeah, Elf is my, I always say to people, Elf is never yours until it's in your bucky. I mean, those things are so, jy weet hoe hulle spring. Ek het al gehoor van ou wat 'n elf gevang het en op pad huis toe. Hy elf uit sy bakkie het gespring, so hy is nie eens joune.
Tot jy moet.
Ja, so nee, ons is, this actually still, it happened, I think it was March this year. It was, late afternoon, a couple of us spoke, and the westerly tends to warm up the water, brings in the elf. And the westerly, as everything well predicted, we did our homework, and then yes, and laat maar te kom die suidewind op, and yes, and hy nek die hele besigheid in mekaar, water raak koud, and yes, and nou is almal is daar, so 8 ouens, ons het al die aas, ons wil elf van, die groot elf daar. And then I took me back, was fishing with different people in different areas, you know, you learn a lot of skills and techniques, and I said to the guys, look, we can try this, I've done it before, worked, and we pulled 8 buckies, all facing the sea, and the idea then to get a lot of these buckies have really nice, I mean, you know, the headlamps and LED lights and things, so we can warm up the water. So we targeted a stretch of water like 100 by 300 meters, and then but now it's difficult because you need to regulate. I was looking at about 20-21 degrees, a good feeding temperature, and we kept one. We kept one, I started laughing. Things raak goed raak teen mekaar, en maak nou klaar, ons het nou genoeg vis. En dan moet ons die bakkies jump. And I think one of the bakkies started, but a friend of mine, he's got a Land Cruiser dual battery system, we kept his bakkie aside to jump us. And yes, but as it laat aan, en het raak donker, en is teen mekaar, en ek is nou hierdie een bakkie jump, en laat hy ry, en jump, en laat hy ry. Nou begin die jumper lees, jy weet myself, jy wat elektronik so goed is, nou begin die discolor die jumper leads het kleen, en is donker, nou kan ek nie sien nie, man, en die laaste week is een Land Rover, en ek sit die bloody jumper leads verkeerd om, en pak in het Land Rover caught fire.
Ja.
En yes, and now, and I got a fright, and I check the ouwe, we staan net terug, whatever, but now, the people don't know, when I finished my studies, I worked at Scotland Yard, at the forensics. I was more at the back of the yard, just keeping the yard naked. So I understand the whole explosion fire story. So I get to say about the gasoline, the fuel will only burn or detonate under pressure. So just took like the plop, the funny petrol thing off, and it just went, and then, but it's the oil. The oil is the big danger. Okay. But I check it pretty hook from my oog uit, but die Land Rover was so oil in the gip. In any case, the thing started burning, die binnengoed brand was somewhere, die seat covers en die goed, en nou praat ek met die ouwe, en die Land Rover, en nou start die ding wil die brand hier. En die ouwe het verseker, hy wil die ding nou uitbrand. En ek sê, jy olie, die Land Rover olie, en hy sê, he put olie in this morning, en hy sê, okay, nou tap van die ouwens olie af, I had always got in chubby oil in my bakkie, so. En dus die ding net aan die brand kan kry, en eventually, en die ding lekker vlam gevat, en het lekker uitgebrand, en al Terrence Simpson, nou dik van die vis, en ek bel vir hom, en hy had al die roosterkoeke, en goed is, en al Terrence came over, brood is, en braai grits, en brooikies, en confit, en wat nog heel. En, so we braaiing the elwe, en with the smoke, we smoking some of the elwe, and we also eating lekker. And it was a special
event. So you spoke about like where you were with this buddy and your wife asked how's he doing. Well, it was a very good buddy of yours. And you said you don't know, you went fishing, you didn't go for a picnic. Good buddy of yours?
Bonnie.
Look, you can do a shout out to your buddies. Let them know you're thinking about them.
I'm scared I leave someone out. And then,
okay,
then
for those
and then I lose followers. I've got 2 followers now.
Oh, you got
two. If I lose one, I'm going to be before I begin.
What's the name of your YouTube? Have you got a YouTube channel?
I started one, but it was actually, but to be perfectly honest with you, it was more a means of sharing because you make a 6 or 7 minute video.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was more a means of sharing the content.
But so, the channel is running.
It's the Small Easy. People call me the Small Easy.
But what's the name? Is that the name of the channel?
I don't think it has a name. It's just if you want to look at the videos, we can maybe put a link up.
We'll put a link up.
My YouTube.
Anyone on Facebook?
But my YouTube name is The Small Easy.
I think. The Small Easy on YouTube, guys. Go and please follow the channel. Check that videos out. Go onto Facebook as well.
Look, if you're not following in order, just go and
That's fine. I actually, I just would like to do that in sequence because I've got a sequential mind, a sequential gearbox.
There we go.
So after just fishing Hans Bay, guys, one of the easiest places you can ever fish. All you do is as you drive into town, listen to what the locals tell you, and you just go do the opposite. So if they tell you. As you tell you first is on, you must move whatever. And can you see me hotel too?
Yeah,
as you always say, but then he come a fussy, that come a fussy, and me see come. So it's easy as that. So that was Hans Bay. Then you went. I went through school. As I said, I was in second in what's called in Oudtshoorn. The surf fishing is a great in Oudtshoorn. En dan is maar afgaan vakantie, altijd een stokje in die kar, en ons vang een beetje bootvis, en die en die, en dan befriended this lady, Lindy Wagner, and they started visiting, en het was vrijdagmiddag, 2:00, na week, strijsbaar, en her dad's called Bachies, he's actually from the Strand, but he then started operate from, going from snook to yellowtail fishing.
Okay.
And then opportunities arose for fishing commercially, getting on the boat. He knows I loved it, and he helped and guided me a lot. And I learned, a lot. Most of what I've learned today was because of, you need to understand commercial fishing. And here's a tip, you guys want tips. Fishing is a time game.
Yeah.
The fish bite me, yell at me, and as the fish, there you can see on that boat, you can't actually see because I put this so groot. The I can already see what four in the cops at them. It's 27-foot ski craft at night. And then they check some of the oaks when we the Rima 12-mile bank to and then to and down to and funny owens crane any fish, you wacht for fish, leave for fish, and check if any owens fat no matter a glass of a geiki and funny other owens lay. And then you check one or two oaks, they you mark stropper and they mark liner and 2 or 3 liner in the ocean. I say, ah, so good. And then when that fish starts to bite, you get home tomorrow morning 8-9 o'clock when it's light, and then I begin to see fish from the boat off, and I kick you with 1 buck, and I kick you with 7 bucks.
Okay,
and that's what I learned. Yeah. And old Bachies is a teddy bear, is the nicest, gentlest person you'll ever meet.
Mm.
And those hours only in summer weather dependent, they can only probably go to get to see my 6-7 days a month.
Oh,
and I'm you fun. See, I was an income there, you know? And I could then see him when. He watches the weather, he thinks and makes up his mind and looks at this, and then a switch triggers in that man's head when he starts to say, and he tells his lady, phone the crew. So he's now made that decision, they're going fishing.
Okay.
So switch in his mind, which you can't explain. And I was done dummy in the wrong stand and the fat stand. And then the next morning at 9 o'clock when we're back, and he first off. Same story. So
okay.
It's work.
But so you've got a wealth of experience in terms of fishing. I mean, rock surf, commercial. It's nice. I think it ups your game most definitely.
Yeah.
And like you said, you've read a lot of books and listened to a lot of audios. So I mean, it's good. You equipped yourself with it.
I've got the personality where I often laugh at my call it the Homer Simpson. I don't know if you guys watch the Simpsons. Every episode of it, we never venture. I guess I can't pursue.
Okay.
I've done mountain biking, golfing, whatever, but I've got the personality. As soon as we're sort of semi-master something, then I sort of lose interest. And with fishing, that's
what size mountain bike did you ride?
A medium.
Was your medium? your height looked like a BMX.
No, there's a 42-incher. 42-incher, yeah. 42-inch at the back and 22 in front. And I was just going down. So that I learned, it was, that made me realize, you know, people do things for different. If you want to go have a relaxing day, and meaning no offense, guys, take your dog and your wife and go and picnic on the beach.
Yeah.
Need some water?
If you don't mind.
Get sorry.
guys, this is actually a prank. This is a prank. We're gonna play on Ibi. So that is Eno. That's Eno. And he's gonna pretend. He's gonna pretend like he's choking.
Quickly, Ibi.
Come, Ibi.
Oh!
Okay, I'll just cut that part out. Let me see.
You're right.
I think I'll cut that part out.
You're right. Hey, what the fuck is going on here, Lawrence? Hey, what the fuck?
Oh, shh.
Hey, this guy's in the fit. Lawrence, I can't handle this. Just that you know me, I've got a bad
Oh, guys, Lawrence, what's happening? Keep his grains open, Ibi.
Oh, Lawrence,
my cheese. I can't
handle this shit, though.
Oh, Philip, Ibi, what do you...
Lawrence, I've got a cheese problem here.
Oh. Ibi, look here.
Yay. Oh.
Ibi.
Oh,
shit. Don't
fucking prank
your
life.
Yeah, no, shit. Hold on. Oh, is that the key? Luke, come help. Come help, okay? Philip, Ibi.
Yeah, is that your room? I know. All the time, I had this in the back of my mind.
Bennie, I had a feeling something's gonna happen.
I need to tell him.
Did you tell him? Listen,
guys. This is what happened. So, Uncle Bennie phoned me yesterday to say he's in a prank, Ibi. So I thought, you know what? Yeah, no worries. So, yes, yes, tissues. So, okay. So I told, I can't wait to see that. What happened was Uncle Bennie actually phoned me yesterday to tell me he's in a prank, Ibi. So I was driving to work and I'm thinking, you know what? Let's prank the prankster. And that's exactly what happened. Uncle Bennie said he's going to drink an Eno. And he's making like he's gonna get a fit. And I told Ibi, Ibi must make like he's getting a heart attack.
The prank is
gone. You had to see your face, man. I can't wait to see that. Yo, I had to. We had to prank. No, don't worry. You, but that is.
Oh.
That looks legit, though. Did you try this before? That looked legit.
Huh?
That looked legit.
Yeah, man, you're sucking all my innards in your mouth.
Yo, guys, I must have you. So,
hey, this guy, I don't know. Listen, so guys, just be careful what you see. The Land Rovers make liquor braai bakke. So I'm trying to follow this sheet here. Just trying to look on here.
We're at Barney Bolton now. We're at Barney, fifth line from the...
Fifth line?
Yeah, I made a note arrow going to the right. So that was Strijsbaai. And then
let's just listen rather. It's cheaper, squeaker.
In the Strijsbaai thing, then you know it's started getting into business and bought shares in a company and blah besigheid and family goed bietjie dan ag nee gaan ons go through phases. My foot. And I get over my foot completely.
It's a word for them.
And it was a week at friend of mine at school, Barney Bolton from the Strand, he's going to buy no bias canvas. And the point I want to make with Barney is,
guys, we had to prank the prankster. I always wanted to do something like that, you know that?
Okay, as you went now.
Did I do it well though?
Did you, what way did you mind when you
said that? No, no, God, the tech guy, life prank.
And I told him early on, if he does have hyperbrain, he said, might get a heart attack.
Yeah, no.
Do you think it was legit?
Yeah, no, I did. It's like the Leon Schuster where that... Where's my director?
Where's my director?
No, well done, Lance.
The wheel
turns.
Yeah.
So, old Barney. So, we went to school together. We both... he was my senior. We played scrum off and then in the matric and then I was at my turn the next year. Very nice guy. Very, very nice. He actually went... they called it interior decorating. Ambulance was now matric in Engeland. Okay,
okay.
Teltbak. It's interior decorating. I think it was geverf.
Okay.
And then he came back, made a couple of bucks. And then... he had friends in Jongensfontein.
Okay.
And he stayed with them for a year. Mm. And his rent was basically supplying fish and food and whatever.
Wow.
That's true.
That's nice.
My wings out. And he fished 6 o'clock in the morning. He was out of the house and he came back in the evenings. And that guy knows. I can't even, you probably won't take it to work to Jongensfontein. Get that out. Yeah, it's my scam or whatever. Okay. It's only, but anyway, so Bennie developed a wealth of knowledge of the area, and we cast in places where if you go there by yourself, you can just stop on your back. So this guy, and he's the point I want to make with someone like Bennie is he doesn't post videos. No one knows him in fishing in numbers and in any of the fault line channels and what have you. But I'm man enough to admit he fishes. He also doesn't fish a lot because he's busy with, you know, obviously work and family and stuff. But we'll do maybe 4 or 5 trips a year, and he outfishes me
every time.
Not that I'm saying I'm that good, but he's just so much better. Okay. And he's the bait legend. He loves making. I think liever for ass markers for fish fang, but I get all ass gevat wat hy gemaak het that I took to when I go fishing with around where around said he's never seen this before. So
the type of bait you're talking about now.
The quality at which he
you know what? I think that's a big thing, and we've got a guy in our group, Ali Tofa. He's a good angler, and he's exceptionally. He's bringing me the water. He wants to throw water over. It's like right before I get wet in my rather water. We're on the point system here, guys. We're on line number subsection 5 point something.
So as less now, geen antwoord nou. Vir vriende volg my die wat die notas by het. A thing that I think they give away my age, but I'm not 21 anymore. We didn't have social media back in the day. So I think there's, again, they're taking you back. I love fishing sort of Gordons Bay Harbour Island. I love catching mullet from the harbour wall.
Okay.
Said to a lot of people that they want me to take their children, teach them how to go fishing and do this and do that. They say, "What? Take buy cook your half loaf in a 8 foot stocky or whatever, and your slug hookies. Go to Harbour Island wall. That's how you learn to fish." You said, "I locals," what I said, "where vang jy 'n emmer hardes langs jou, dan kry jy 'n bytie." That's when you start learning to make plans. Check what they're doing.
Exactly.
Ander traces, ander lens, ander hoeke, ander knope, gooi dieper, gooi vlakker, sit 'n float aan. And die ouens, you guys obviously sell tackle, so I'm going to be very selective what I say about tackle. I'm a genuine. Let me just say this. Those guys fish, you'll never see their posts, you'll never see their fish, you'll never see the photos. With a 3-piece rod, of which now is a Nissan gearbox with the Ford.
Know what you're saying.
First talk with 3 verskillende stukke, nie een is dieselfde nie, and I
of basic tackle.
And hulle self my hulle wys my die fotos op hulle foon.
Yeah, of course.
So please, I go on trips where die ou pak die ou uit en dan die ou 87 stokke sal hom gebring. Nou besluit jy of hy sy groot belman of sy klein belman of sy kabeljou of sy 11 stok of sy galjoen klip galjoen stok. En dan jy besluit nog, ek gooi sy my hand klein en so dan, tackle's important is an edge. You can buy what you buy the best you can afford.
Of course.
You'll never look back. You don't want to sit at Eisenbach container for 3 days and with a gebreke stok of katrol.
No, absolutely.
So buy the best you can afford. That's my, I've never had someone come back to me and say, you know, he should have spent less. So koop wat jy kan bekostig, look after the stuff. It's not that difficult to maintain. Die ouens doen dit nie, hulle kom by die huis, gooi die goed neer, raai ons wash and rinse and service maar. While we on bait and tackle, probeer, ek weet Rian en al die gidse almal, ek sal nooit met 'n stok op 'n bakkie se dak ry nie. Vir al as jy byvoorbeeld sê 3-4 ure, when you buy a new reel, you guys sell them.
Yeah.
I would take that ons vang ons nou maar met grinders. So ek sal hy splinter nuwe grinder vat. First thing I'll do is I'll spray it down with like something like DWF of any kind of water repellent. And just do like it creates like a foam coating on the that prevents against scratches, rusting and what have you. And dan gaan ek en you go fish with it once. And then you come back and then you tighten the I've lost, I'm not going to mention the real names and things, but I've, with that casing at the back coming loose, I broke the drive gear. Oh, okay. And that's 70% of the rock pick. Oh, my screw is lost rock. But there is straight lock up, but I think this opposite is a tape with a plug.
Yeah.
So I would go fish with it. Ek sal eers almal tighten, maar as jy gaan ry, jy gaan blombos ry op grondpaaie met 'n met katrol op jou dak. Daai skroefies gaan loskom, ek beloof jou.
Ja, no, we never travel and we're going to Overberg. My reels are off, my rods are on my roof. But my reels are always off, even coming home. Yeah. Even if you've got reel socks, it's not enough, especially the dusty roads and things like that.
So yeah, it's a tip, just try. Yeah. And kyk, maak hy skroefies vas. Ek gebruik Worth se thread lock.
Yeah,
and
it works.
Yeah.
No, absolutely. I mean, those are all the little tips, guys. Follow this gentleman's been through it. So when you get your reel, this is what he recommends. If it works for him, I'm sure it could work for you. If it doesn't work for you, at least he's still sharing with us, and that is what it's all about. tackle is not cheap. I'm going to tell you something. Here's a reel, one of my reels. And if I buy a reel, so you would probably think I get that cost price, right? Glad nie meneer. If I tell my wife, listen, I want that reel, and you sorted me, she says, yes, no problem. Then she'll check, she tell me, that's what the reel costs. I says, yeah, okay. That's what we sell it for. She says, yes, but that's what you'll pay for it. Except about coming in my business, she tell me, no. It might be our business, but if you were going to buy it somewhere else, you would have had to pay that price at any other shop. Exactly. She said, yes. She said, pay yourself because I need a share of that. Example, okay, moi man, moi. So I've got very little tackle because I can't afford it right now. You know?
Yeah, it is. And
it's not cheap. You have to look after it. You're right.
Look after your stuff. And when you go on, a lot of us enjoy these Monday weekends where you go away for 2-3 days with the guys. I get for elk from my control, I've got a space pool. Yeah. And the reason for that space pool is because that spool's bright is full and it's got a leader on. See, first bite, so take your leaders on it. It changed my spool. It's about, it's again, see, first one, heel start, in die nacht, in die donker, ek het drie lijn, as hy lijn geknoop raak, kaas die tijd vir knoop uithaal, jy kan hy knoop morgen ochtend gaan uithaal by die huis. Skop hy goed een kant toe, vir die ander een.
Are you fishing mainly grinders?
I do have multipliers, be man enough to admit I don't know if I can cast them anymore.
Okay.
It is a fantastic reel to, it's an enjoyable to fight a fish on a multiplier. Dit is maar net weer die ou story, nou by die vis en jy sit staan en maak 'n kraan is reg en die ander ou.
Exactly.
So nee, by nou mens, ek het nie voorkeer afkeer nie, ek vis met, well, maybe there's a development opportunity for you entrepreneurs. Die kraan is het nie a warning system, het nie a ratchet system het. And when fishing at night with two rods,
you want to hear it.
You want to be able to hear.
I was telling somebody that came in here. It wasn't on the podcast. We were just discussing, and with the the guy at the drug rehab, I was asking what's so great about fishing. I said you won't understand. When you start fishing and you catch your first fish, you hooked. There's no doubt. I tell him, but let me put it to you this way: if you were watching a program on TV and you press pause. I said, are you going to watch that same pick for 30 seconds non-stop while it's on pause? He says, probably not. I said, let me explain to you like this. If we fish at night and I got a glow stick on and I cast my rod and somebody talks to me and my rod is here and he's busy chatting me, I'm telling him, how fast? And I turn him around so that when I look at him, I see my rod. I said, we watch that glow stick for hours. I mean, don't get sick of it because we're waiting for that moment. That's fishing.
Yeah.
That is fishing.
I do as well. And I'll say to someone the other day, what do you do when you've got he ran, it was 8 oor, reg rondom sy kop. As he'll tell you, I'd feed stock in the water, and he'll be fishing, and he'll be helping clients, and he'll tell me afterwards what I could have done better or worse.
Now we're going to tag Rian in this video.
Ach, jy kan dit uit-edit wat ons is.
Rian, we're keeping this for you, brother.
we're good friends.
Yeah, no.
On more levels than just fishing.
Oh, there we go, guys.
And then, watch out over here. When you're standing on a rock with a rod waiting for a bite, there's not a hell of a lot to do. Kijk, waar jy jou volgende. I think one of, unfortunately, none of the books that are out there are not written for false bay conditions. It was written for the Batsy Rivier on the kant still by.
Breder.
Yeah, nog verder af, op by, almost in Muscle Bay.
Is it not Gourits?
Ja, Nicky Lawrence en al die onze boeken is geskryf.
Okay.
Kijk, as beginsels, which you can't get away from. And obviously in Gars talk about water reading and isolated sandbanks and sandbars and rips and cuts and things. Okay, ons vlieg nie met helikopter sitte nie. Yeah. Those aerial footage, you can't, it looks completely different from the side. So.
Absolutely. Mm.
So that's not that easy. Yeah, now I gotta...
We need to find out where you stopped.
To watch, guys. He's reading, he's going line for line. We just chilling.
Yeah.
We wishing, I'm watching my glow stick now.
And I will never take my eyes off it.
Yeah.
Because my neck is here. But take care, sometimes you can, or even if I fish, busy biting up, I always, but take care, can you obviously like a suck scene and so on. But yeah, I'm already stopped up. So last we were at with Barney, so did a lot of wonderful trips with Barney. Still by.
You think we're gonna get to meet Barney? I'd like to meet this Barney.
Yeah, he doesn't drink anymore, so I think he's more time than me.
Well, if he's not drinking, then which means we're not gonna be that interesting team, because normally people drink to make other people interesting.
Yeah. I'll have a Choma. I'll have a chat, and I think he can do.
I think
it's again. It's about wanting to share what you want and what you don't want to share. So let me have a chat.
Yeah, we'd love to meet Bonnie. Sounds like a really interesting time.
But yeah, no, he's a legend. He's very good.
So tell me something, right? So, I mean, you got a very rich story to tell in terms of where you started with Opa Gansby, and then of course even ending up in commercial, and the fact that you've educated yourself very well with angling. And you're also very practical. I can hear when you talk, you're very practical, like you're saying, when they're showing you, for example, pics from above, from the eyes view from the surface, very different. So you're 100% with that. But in your fishing right now, because you've mentioned more than one, I can't remember how old I'm saying, because I'm 50. But where are you now with your fishing? In terms of how often do you still go out? Like you said, you're fortunate enough to be able to go out in the week. I thought opening up a tackle shop will give me a lot of time to go fish in the week, man. This tackle shop, I said this tackle shop is just a tromps on the trailies, né? You know, but I mean, where are you? If you were to say, how many times this winter season have you gone out? Have you caught Khali? How much Khali have you caught? What is it that you've done this winter from the start of this the winter season now?
I'm a very karma natural sea person, so I can't eat telling, and sometimes I say they put that fish back.
But you've caught.
But three things gemeten, so you take three things gemeten. But yeah, I bet it's like 40.
It's not a shabby number.
No, and yeah. I will, if I go to like a trip to Gans Bay, like catch, I mean, also die dag gegaan, vang jy 2-3 galjoene vir die naweek of wat, yes, I moet allemaal sien die foto's en die goed. I'll catch 10. If I don't catch 10, from 6 in the morning, okay, nou winter is miskien, kom ons sê van 7 tot 6, what's it, 11 hours?
Yeah, 11 hours.
I would want to catch 10, with 3 spot moves.
Jy wil nou namens gaan die eiko?
I'm sure it's more than that.
How fast, meneer? You're going to need more than that, you know.
Yeah. How many 10?
2.
Yeah, but in the first half an hour.
No, actually, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it's not, people that know me know I'm easygoing person. People that might see me for the first time, I think I'm arrogant, but it's confidence.
Yeah.
And I think Ryan's touched on that, where I've got a great mentor in life, a guy from America, Grant Cardone. I don't know if you've ever, he's a life coach and a sales coach. I'm very passionate about sales. And he talks about going into a negotiation or doing a sale or doing a meeting and being able to predict the outcome.
Okay.
And I say, because they know something. K-N-O-W. K-N-O-W. They know something.
They know something.
And I can go into a session and know stuff. And
yeah,
that's the difference. Knowledge is power. And
absolutely.
But you can only develop that confidence by actually catching fish.
Yeah.
So what I quickly wanted to touch on was, yeah, so then it was the whole Gans Bay, Streys Bay, commercial, blah, blah, blah. And then again, then it's the child, almost like I bore my first child. My vrou, hey, ons stop also net hier so. My vrou ons werk saam, ons eet saam, ons slaap saam, ons belei saam, ons doen alles saam. En alles wat ek hier is en vandag is, Annika, my wife, love you to bits, my babe.
There we go.
En sy support my en alles. In actual fact, omdat ons so baie saam ben, sê ons, so, lekkie water woensdag, jy moet nie slag nie, jy moet nie slag nie water kom. So, dit nie had daar.
Kan ek iets wat Annika sê? Hmm? Annika, ne?
Yes.
Can I say something to Annika? You're a very lucky woman. You know why I say that? Not just because you got a great guy, most people you got a great guy, but you have a lot of funny moments. Yeah. Liver's lucky,
it's not, Annika. It's not always.
And I'm sure she's figured out, because I'm going to listen to the conversation, I'm figuring out, and this guy's talking about bike losing scent in the air, 5 meters, what, 5 minutes in the air? And then I realized, Nierman, that's another story. But I'm sure she's got you figured out then.
Yeah.
She's got you figured out. Well done.
Yeah, we're very opposites though. She's like, come here, I think I'm going to have two times first from the spot off.
Nah. So guys, just as a matter of interest, this interview is going on his own. We just sitting. Carry on.
Yeah, well, that's...
Next line.
So then, after all that, I had a kind gehad, and then I was almost for 3-4 years, you know, became the kind and so on, and then I started... You know, visvang is maar altijd in die achtergrond. En check the house at my kasser. En dan draai ek uit, figure, waar is die plek? En dan rijd ek met die kar. En ek sê, nee, ek rijd die plek hier.
Jy het geweet waar my kasser is?
No, I never know.
And you live in Gordons Bay?
In Strand.
In Strand.
So,
how did you figure that out?
Ek denk Rian. Of ek het iemand gevolg of gekyk.
Oh, jy doen met Rian Rademeyer? Of Rian Lambrecht?
Ja, Rian Lambrecht. Nee, so, ek weet nie, op 'n manier het ek uitgegaan, ek het 'n bike, ek het so BMW, omdat ek 'n midlife crisis, een van die adventure bikes gehad, en dink ek, toe kom ek enig per ongeluk van Byron Pell se kant af. Maar dis die klippe, toe sien ek nie, gaan ek my vrek val, toe ry ek maar weer, maar toe figure ek nou, ek kan nie like, I'm not sure. And then I started checking around on ISFN, and what was, again, people think I'm blowing smoke up his ass, I don't owe you anything, you don't owe me anything. So, alles wat ek sê is from the heart. En, toe sê ek maar, weet ek wil weet graag saam met jou gaan hengel, sê, hey, now at the time, I was still working at Ford, I was shooting for ISFN and I've got Bhutan's videos and cameras, but you can't go take me with, or you can't go fishing with me, but as you each will vraag, I mean, that guy's got probably 10, 20,000 followers, yeah. And he didn't know me from a, and I just said, I probeer dit, maak so, and I appreciate that. And then when the opportunity arose, without making it a long story, when the opportunity arose where he started this, I enjoyed that entrepreneurial spirit, so I booked with him and we started...
On one of his trips?
Yeah, on one of his trips and fishing and coaching and whatever, and that's where I think he actually also referred to, I wrote here 5% small things, 500% results. It's small things, guys. Which in my view, think of me what you want, call me what you want. I went from a good angler to an elite angler.
Yeah,
nice. And I think that is what Rian is able to do, to take somebody who's never fished and catch a fish.
Yeah.
To take somebody that knows a little bit about fishing and help him maybe to catch his own fish.
Yeah.
And then taking, I mean, I believe he's been selected as a coach now for Paul, for the Boland B team for the juniors or something.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. Well done.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, so that is the levels at which one can operate.
Mm. Mention more of your buddies. Their names, come, let us hear.
They want to know.
Stefan, and guides. Just quickly on guides. Guys, you don't, everywhere you guys sit in the mornings at work at 9 o'clock and they check the Rian post the video or Stefan post the video, 8 o'clock, you bucky trek and also they say, dream job. People just, I have made a mention in a post, just think carefully, it's this work. Jy moet besef nie hierdie mense, hy ou moet 4 stokke werk, hy moet gooi, hy moet vir mense leer, hy moet met mense praat, hy moet aas aansit, hy moet skuif.
Yeah.
It's, if you know, you're either born for that or not.
Yeah.
Me sitting here, I pose no threat to any guy in the Palsway area.
Yeah.
It won't be me, but I get a little, I've been with the guys, I've been to help them, and I just use the respect. Wonderful what you guys do.
I want to share something with you. So to all the guides out there, the fishing guides that's doing charters on our beach, right? It their office is the beach, but remember in the cold morning when we look out at the Nang Nearscope, those guys are going out. When they're going, they're not just going fishing. They're going to earn that living. And remember, they also have that pressure on their shoulder that they need to give their client a good time.
Yeah.
So you need to know what you're doing. So it's not just the fact that these guys are good and now you see them catching fish with clients. They need to learn the game. For example, in your industry or my industry, if somebody brought me a motor car to repair, I need to know how to repair it and able to be able to do the job for the client. And guide work, it's brilliant. Mm. And to all those guides out there, be it on the our coastline or any other province. Because I'm going to tell you something. We've watched a couple of videos where guys are saying, oh, now we're also starting to do charters and whatever, whatever. You saw them go out once or twice and that was it. And they disappeared. And you never heard about it again. But the Rians, the Vickers, the Clayton, the guys that I know, Stefan, I don't know if you're speaking about Stefan Swanson.
No, I think it was a wrestler, pro wrestler. Mary Swanson's
so I mean
Stefan Oosthuizen.
Okay, Stefan. But Anna and Stefan Swanson, he's also coming on to us soon. He's in here, very good guy.
Apologies, I've never heard of you, Stefan.
No. He does the shark cage diving. Stefan Swanson is also a SA caster. I think he does that 5-minute bait in the air type of thing.
Yeah, maybe I can
show him a tip or two. Yeah. So I mean, these guys, hats off to them, eh?
Yeah.
Because also remember something. When you go into office, you're still getting paid for that time that you're there. But when it's storming outside, you're in office, you're getting paid. When it's storming outside, these guys are not earning because they can only get paid on what they do. So now I have a lot of respect to them. And we've had Rian in here. I'm not sure if you watched that video, but it was amazing sitting in his company, just listening. And he says it so, ach man, you read Rofwater, Frotter, Ars, you know, that. He says it off like it's joke. Yeah. Easy peasy, something brilliant.
You know what I would sum it up as? I'm going to ask you a question. What does he do on an off day?
Prep for the day, must go work.
This guy's that on his off days, that guy goes fishing by himself. So if that doesn't just on friends, if you're heading down Strijsby area, Stefan Oosthuizen, awesome guy. He'll take on the thing is, guys, you can. It depends on your level of experience. We want to catch fish. Guys will tell me, yeah, we didn't catch anything. But yeah, that was like a weekend. And why did you go? You could have wanted to stay.
Yeah.
So it costs money. You travel, you collect bait, invest in that couple of bucks. And did the guy put you on a fish? That's what you that's what
when
you
I did.
So Stefan, JP, that was in here before me, a good friend of mine. But these guys, that's hardcore fishing. I've not got the ideal vertical build for reef fishing. So thanks for all the invites. And jy weet hoe kom ek hier saam gaan nie. Johan Lategan from Crazy for Fishing, die Clarence Drive. Few people that know that area as well as him. Victor, as I said, it's great that he's still alive. Even though not posting a lot of catches. And then a good friend of mine, old Neil Kutzer, who's my best man on my wedding. He's from the East Rand, from Kempton Park.
Okay.
And we started, was it barbers and carp goed gevang.
Okay, oh, pretty short. Okay.
And that guy, and then his dad bought a holiday home in St. Lucia. And I was still a bachelor and I had more time and money to myself. I would fly up. But there was it, and they got into Boatvis van a roof. We're trolling and I think, and he's today is a Protea.
Okay, then.
Protea angler.
Well done. Well, what's his name?
Neil Kutzer.
Well done.
Protea
well
angler done. from the East Rand. And they're doing a lot of putting back into their take underprivileged children, kinders met gestremdhede goed and take.
There we go. Nice. Guys, that's what we like.
Eh? Wonderful guy. So yeah, that is, I think that's some trendy Owens, what they've got genoemd. And yeah, freshwater. It was my business. I don't know what your future expansion plan is good, but you also asked me where am I now. Again, going to sound arrogant, but I've pretty much caught. I get middle of all fang what I will fang, and maybe a large garrick. It's still on my bucket list. But I'm getting with my wife and kids. Like my lighty is, he's a bit impatient, and see what is maybe the wind come up and it rain and the tide. So was it the fast water thing now begin? So I can I fang wiki bass and D and I. But it's a guy that I do want to mention. It was also we fished a lot, but ons gaan ook wat baie en ons werk goed. It's Karel van Hoek.
Okay.
Karel van Hoek, you guys are welcome. Freshwater guys, Kaap guys. Get on to Karel's.
Is he in Cape Town?
He's in Stellenbosch.
Okay.
They manage 3 private farms in Stellenbosch.
Okay.
Of which 30 kilo carp on a weekend, no problem.
Sure.
If you know what you're doing.
Okay, so look, we're going to put Benny's details in the bio.
Yeah.
In terms of his channel, where you can private message him. And if anybody wants to get into Fresh Water Fish, I'm sure you will then pass on some details.
Yeah, a lot of these things happen. I never planned it. Now what started is I was invited to a farm just to spend time with my kid because we also never met mekaar verby. En toe sê die vrou, dan vraag ek my wat is haar en so, maar ek sê vir my, my liggie, want ek gaan jy, as haar ding is wat swem, gaan ek omvang. En sy sê nee, maar hulle het baie bas. So okay. Ek sal check, en kom ek haar, check ek die plek uit, maak my somme en ek vang een paar bas. Ja, sy die eerste bas wat ek vang, WhatsApp ek haar en sy sê my eers of sy die bas kan opsit op hulle, maar ek dog aan, ek sê vir my dog, jy sê jy so baie bas, en hulle wil nou opsit vir die bemarking, wat en ek is so, toe nou, dis die sel, ek gaan nou vir Hans Hoek toe, to review freshwater destinations.
Nu sê die going, ja.
Ja, so just to go,
lovely.
Check out the venue, sien wat byt, ja, so vaarswater is iets wat, wat's lekker van, is bykie iets anders.
As ons nou between blij,
Yeah. No, we're getting. I apologize. I'm actually talking too much.
I'm gonna
say one more thing, and then I think
the rest is.
So I've spoken about. I'm a very analytical person from my background. about 2 years ago, every session, because there's things. There's wind, man, water temperature, wave period, wave size, a lot of things that you analyze. And then every session I would see what I caught and then I would analyze it on a spreadsheet.
Okay.
And
that's fishing technical.
And it took about 6 or 7 months. And then I sat down one day and it's well, half my process. I just started laughing. I said, you're going to drive yourself crazy. It just doesn't work like that. There's basics that one needs to look at. But as you will, ek kyk videos, as plekke wat ouens vis vang. Honest, ek sal nie eens gestop het om my stok van die bak afhaal. Boys, that's fishing.
Yeah.
So yeah, don't be afraid to try different things. Kyk wat die ouens leer, but find mentors in business as well as in fishing. Find people that have done this before you. You
can either know it.
Go the hard route and...
Absolutely.
And settle yourself or find somebody to guide you. Just it gaan oor tyd and enjoyment, you know. And then my last tip, and then as I said, if there's any other things you want to ask, last tip that I got that very few people do is when with social media there's it elke dag is al 4-5 visse word gepost. That I was nou kwyl hulle oor die ou wat nou staan met die vis. I never look at the fish. Look at the fish. Look at the bait that's in his mouth. Look at the water.
Yeah.
In the conditions in which he's caught it. Look at the trace length. Look at the hook he's using. There's a wealth of knowledge in that photo, which no one's looking at.
Yeah, and everyone's looking at the negative.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, with the 46 centimeter galjoen gevang. Ek het nie gesien as 'n galjoen nie. Ek het gesien dit wit mossel gewees. Die water is plat. Ek geskuim hier's 'n gaatjie.
Yes.
So
100%.
Definitely, yeah.
I always say when the guy's catching next to you guys, please watch what he's catching on. And what he's catching it with.
Mm.
Simple. It is spot on because angling is learning.
Yeah.
Mm. And you know, it's like you say also, you can watch the conditions, but this is the funny thing about fishing, guys. You can go today and hypothetically, you've got a southeaster blowing and the waves are rolling 5 second periods and you've got a 1.6 plus meter swell in that proximity and you catch 2-3 fish. Come tomorrow, you got the same condition on the same spot. Doesn't mean the fish is there.
But
exactly. The fish could have moved, and now you start hunting.
It can tweer. It can tweer later. Can it all
there we go.
So what you need to do on a session is you need to plan. You need to find the fish. You need to find out what they're feeding on. And as you goed begin bite, dan sit die tyd vir stroppies maak.
Yeah. There we go. There we go.
Fish it for that 45 minutes. Guys, ek is raak nou. Ouens sê, oom, ek het al opgegee. So as jy wil sê, oom, as ek oom, is fine. Maar die ouens kyk, ek hardklip as die vis byt tussen my sandpen en die bakkie. Ons skuif, ons gooi, ons is nie ek stok ingooi met 6 maande oud mossel, gaan sit op 'n kampstoel en that's what you it's what you in for. Maar vat jou kinders en jou hond saam en dan gee jy nooit niks van nie. En as jy wil vis vang, is werk.
Nou, there you go, guys. Mr. Benjamin Derek, Bennie.
Yes, he's a top prop.
We need to see that, prof. We still got time here. Benny's gonna show us one more thing.
Yeah, so no, this is actually a gift that I brought you guys. This was the after the long casting clinics and things that I held, this the sinker that I developed. So it's the PV45 Evo, which I designed, and I casted this 389 meters into a southeasterly. But just a lot of
I see you named it.
No, it's actually a permit. You need to have a permit in order to, because
can I have a look at it?
Yeah, it was my gift to you. But please, just don't let it get into the. You cannot cast this without a permit. You can.
Okay, guys.
Will
you show pilot license?
You need a pilot license for that. Just show our people over there.
So speak to me. Get a permit.
Can we get the permit through you?
Yes, you can.
Okay, there we go.
Also, ek sê kyk ook, jy kan nie 'n woonbeer te goed gooi en
ja.
Hy gaan baie keer wat gebeur is waar jy kan met die en onthou dis permits are provincial specific. So if you cast into a
Thomas, I mean seriously. Your application for this?
It's a sinker that Ryan started using, which I think he got from his uncle or somebody.
Okay.
I bought the mold and it's just a magical sinker. The thing hardly gets stuck, and if it does get stuck, if it does get stuck and losses some chibiki lines, get, then
I think Andy's just staying on that.
Now look, this thing is painted too nice to get amongst the rocks. Eh?
So you painted it yourself as well.
So I didn't have an ice 300 micron epoxy with a long cast film.
Not any epoxy, guys. 300 micron. Yeah. So I'm going to tell you what we're going to do. This sinker. Alongside this shit, it's going to remain in our memorabilia.
Yeah.
Remember something, our podcast is here, and it's for as long as the internet and the social media platforms are there, this is going to remain there, and we will continue our podcast. But this is the moment we say to you, Benny, thank you very much.
Yeah.
And to each and every person that comes onto our podcast, that accepts the invite or contacts us to come onto the podcast, we feel honored. And the knowledge and the humor and everything, this was something very different for me. I loved it.
Yeah.
From the word go, including the email part. I hope I played my part of well. I got the gotter. And but once again, my friend, thank you very much.
Yeah. Yes, honest mind. Thank you so much. Thanks.
You know, and we're definitely gonna do this again. There will be follow-ups. We hope to get Uncle Barney here. And but once again, we wish you only about the best in everything. Your fishing, your family life, your career, your entrepreneurship, and the motivation that you put forth to others. Don't stop. Keep going.
Awesome. Thank you so much, guys. Honor was mine. Thanks for each. It's mutually beneficial. It's
yeah.
That to me is what fishing. I said I was going to stop, and I never stopped. the people that you meet. Again, it's that to me is an honor and a privilege. Like a lot of people that I've never met them. I do meet them from time to time. But so most of them just commenting through. I've got people, I've got a guy, Indian Peters, I think he stays in the NTs.
Mm.
Practically feel like you know the guy, you know, but we've never seen or met. And through that comes a responsibility. And I said, I do have a serious side.
Yeah.
Only lanky. Well, that comes with a responsibility. So where I am in my life is, as I said, when I identify people, it's about art and passion and whatever.
Yeah.
And then to spend time with them or coach them, not only about fishing, but it's to me, it's like it's building into someone's life. Life is tough and difficult and it's lelijk to take care. And just to say to them, you know, skyfie die kaksel altyd wees. Move it aside. Focus on the positives. Focus on the opportunities. Leer, luister, vat verantwoordelijkheid. And
you guys heard it?
Be good on to others and keep it real.
Perfect. Guys, also just keep in mind to go, if you haven't yet, make sure you guys subscribe to the Hook It Casting Customs channel as well as Hook and Grill. And once again, thanks to our lovely guest and Fanny, and thanks again for sharing all your stories.
Mention Benny's channel name.
I will leave it in the description. I think you forgot the name.
Yeah, no, but it's just this. I don't know. There's 10 or 15. It's just funny. Yes.
follow
Real Fishing channel.
No worries. All right, guys. Thanks again. We out.